Hello, welcome to my dog training course, and I am going to give a brief introduction on how this course is going to proceed and the philosophy of the dog training that we are going to use. We are going to do what is called as clicker training or marker training. Both are the same, they mean the same thing and they describe the same kind of training, and we use punishment-free positive training methods, and we make the animal work because it enjoys working, and we don't punish the animal for non-compliance. So these few words somewhat describe the training methodology that we'll be using. So the equipment you need to do this training is a bait bag, and you need a clicker. Or if you don't have a clicker, or if you don't want to use a clicker, you can use your mouth as a clicker. You can make any short unique noise that the dog doesn't hear often. I use the word yes, y-e-s, yes. It should be short and sharp. If not, you can use a clicker. Here is a list of things that I wish I had known when I started training dogs. So these I call as golden rules that I've learned through my experience, through my mistakes. So there are a few things that you need to know before you start training a dog, and these are like the foundational rules that you cannot violate. Okay, the first rule is there is no place for anger or frustration while training dogs. Okay, the second rule is always keep it short and intense. Don't train for hours and hours together. Train for a few minutes and stop before the dog wants to stop. This is number two. Number three is always keep the dog winning, by which I mean never ask the dog to do something that it may fail doing. Always ask the dog something that most probably he will do successfully. So this is another important rule. The next rule is always prepare and plan your training session ahead of time. Just don't go there and wing it. Make sure that you have all the items that are needed to do the training. And then on top of that, make sure that your environment will be conducive for training, and also ensure that your dog is in the right mood to train. So you have to plan and prepare for 2 to 3 times longer than the amount of time you may train. So if I'm going to train for 3 minutes, I'll spend like 12 minutes preparing for the training. The next rule is be flexible with your training, by which I mean you cannot go out there and say that today I'm going to train my dog to sit. It just doesn't work. What you have to do is, you may have some goals. You may want to train your dog to sit, but your dog will dictate what and how much it is going to get trained on that day. So if you cannot deal with that mentally, you should probably not be training dogs. You should always work to your dog's convenience, and you cannot impose your will on your dog. And lastly, never ever get upset or dejected, or even though you don't show it outside, internally you cannot be in that space, in that state, because your dog senses it. And if you really look at it, it's just dog training, right? It's nothing serious. So the world is not going to stop spinning if you don't train your dog. So the most important thing for you is to have fun. Never forget that.